Okay, so I think I have a handle on optimizing HTML and CSS. So are we moving on to the render tree?
Almost. We haven't really talked about JavaScript, and obviously that's an important step. So let's take a look at that.
Okay, well, let me guess. Minify it, compress it, and cache it?
Yep, all of those are good strategies. But for JavaScript, you may have seen PageSpeed Insights also complain about parser blocking scripts. Let's take a look at what that means and how we can optimize it.
I've extended our Hello World page with a simple inline script at the bottom. Let's walk through it. First of all, we reach into the DOM and look for the first span element, which as you can see contains the web performance text. Next, we modify the DOM element by changing its inner text and also changing its CSS properties.
Seems simple enough.
Yeah, this shows that JavaScript can manipulate both the DOM and the CSS object model. It's a very powerful tool. And it gets a bit more interesting from here. Next, we create a new div element, set its text content, CSS color property, and append it to the page. Let's try to load this page on our phone. Notice that the text now says Hello Interactive Students instead of Hello Web Performance Students. And we also have our new element right below it.
Right, as expected. So is there anything here we can do to optimize performance?
Definitely. Optimizing JavaScript could be an entire course, but in this particular example, it's not really the code, but how it's included on the page. Let's take a step back and think about how the browser would go about building this page.